Spiritual Harvest Ministries.
Thank you again, and let our program be what you wanted to be in your son Jesus' name. Amen.
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 Hallelujah. How many of you women need to be refreshed today? Let me see your hands.
Hallelujah.
Boy, it sounds like to me y'all been in the battlefield for the Lord. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Y'all been on the battlefield for the Lord. Look, y'all been bruised and banged up in the spirit. Hallelujah. I tell you, people don't understand. When you fight in the spirit, it takes a toll on your spirit. Physical body.
Amen.
Because you are fighting in the spirit.
That's right.
So I tell you, it takes a toll. So guess what? I was just telling Sister Judy, we have nowhere else to go.
No.
But to the Father. But to the throne room.
That's right. Yes.
But to the Word. Mm-hmm. And it gets hard out here.
Yes.
I mean, sometimes I feel like I'm against the wall and literally being lifted up with my feet just dangling. But I know my God has not left me. He is keeping me. He's keeping you. And he's got us here for a reason. So I just want to say hello to the women of the Word again. To our fall 2024 women fellowship. Hallelujah. Woo. I tell you, we are so grateful to have you ladies here with us today to join us. Because remember, the women of the Word is not just a title, it's a what?
Lifestyle.
And when it comes to the Word, we make it what?
Right.
Let's say it one more time. When it comes to the women of the Word, it's not just a life, it's not just a title, it's a what?
It's a lifestyle.
And when it comes to the Word, we make it what?
Right.
We make it plain. So
hallelujah.
When you leave here today, we're hoping you're going to be refreshed. Be reconnected. We're just excited about being here. Today, we hope you get a chance to relax with your sisters. To refresh with your sisters.
Amen.
And just hang out. I'm hoping more come today. Hallelujah. Because we really do need to be here today to support each other.
Yes.
I can feel it. It's a heaviness here.
Yes.
I can feel it. In the spirit, there's a heaviness here.
Yes.
So we really do need to be refreshed in the presence of the Lord. So today as we go, we're going to reconnect. That means come back together. Amen. Refresh while we're in the presence of the Lord.
Yes.
And we're just going to have fun today, ladies, okay?
Amen.
We're just going to have fun today.
Yes.
We're just going to have fun. Now, you know, we got to throw some word in there to keep that spirit man built up.
Yes.
With all these battles that we're going through.
Yes.
But today, we're just going to have fun and hang out and get in some word and just refresh and reconnect. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So we're going to pass it on to Pastor Brenda, and she's going to take us into the next phase of our fellowship.
Hallelujah. We're going to get into a little praise this morning, but guess what? It's not going to be the regular praise team. Amen. And we're going to have two praise teams, two songs that we all know. And the first person that I'm going to call up as she poses for that picture is Pastor Peggy. You are the praise team leader today for this song.
All right.
Come on up, Pastor Penny. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah.
We're having fun
now
today.
Now you get to pick two other ladies to join you up here. One can be a regular praiser, but you get to pick two. And the other one can't be Sister Jackie Sheely, because she's the other praise leader for the other song. Okay, so look out among you and tell us who you want to sing with you today. One can be a praiser out there. Hallelujah.
She knows. My sister Patricia.
All right. Get you a praise singer.
Okay. Sister Dorothy.
Come on, Sister Dorothy. We're just having a little fun
that's
today.
Right.
Amen.
That's right.
All right, you ladies, get your mic. You know this song.
Amen.
Okay, yeah, I'll get over kind of in the middle light.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Now, they're not going to be singing by themselves. We're going to sing with
right.
them. Amen.
Right. Amen.
Sister Dorothy, will you pass them out a mic?
Oh, we need a mic.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah,
you
gotta have a mic.
Hallelujah.
You gotta have a mic.
And our first song is gonna be God's Grace. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So, Sister Peggy, you gonna take the lead on it, or who's taking the lead on that? She's at home.
Do I know this one?
You know God's grace.
Okay.
She's okay.
We can change.
Huh?
We can change songs if she don't know that.
Oh, she knows it.
Oh.
Yeah, I think
it's Sister Leslie.
Okay. All right. Now we're gonna encourage them now and sing right along with them. Amen.
Hallelujah.
We can do all things through Christ who strengthens us.
Amen.
You don't have us in it, do you, Pastor? Okay. All right, good.
Come on.
So the reason I'm here is my heart. All right, now who are you going to pick with you today?
Sister Angela.
All right. Is she ready?
Oh, okay, come on up here, sister.
I got what you know.
Somebody else can sit at the door. Somebody
wants
to sit at the door.
Pastor Bob can sit at the door.
Pastor Bob can sit at the door. All right, praise team number two.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
We'll get Sister Lashina to lead this song.
Yeah, we'll
watch y'all go that way.
Go that way.
Closer.
Now she's trying not to get us, so y'all got to go.
I'm trying not to get them. Yeah. So y'all got to get
back.
Yeah.
Mama! Because I do that with my friends. It's called and see how they're doing. Because you never know what a person is going through.
That's right.
They might need love. They might be at their last moment.
That's right.
They don't feel love from no one. Because I always never felt love from no one but Miss Davis. She practically took care of me when she was my teacher. I was a little girl. She took care of me. She showed me love by coming to my graduations and stuff like that. Amen. That type of love by just supporting and calling and checking on someone. That's my professor of love. And
Good answer. All right. Anybody want to add to that? I mean, we can add to it.
Yes, we can add to it.
Hallelujah. How can you show love to a sister in the church?
Yeah, that was very good.
It can be anybody. Okay.
Okay.
All right, Sister Samantha. It would be good.
Nice if you would come on up here.
Let's give her a hand clap. Let's encourage her. Come on up here. Hallelujah.
Amen.
How we can show love to one another. How we can show love to one another in the church.
So I want to piggyback off what Krishana said. Mm-hmm. Love is an action word.
Yes,
you,
it is.
You said that, and you said that with your heart, and you, I really felt that. Because
that's right.
You said it how you felt it.
Amen.
Love is an action word. Showing up, that is an act of kindness and love. Just being there for you. Someone to talk to, someone you can text, and they mm-hmm. respond. And you know, how you doing today? Smallest things. So those are actions, you know. Verbalized by love.
Amen. 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 Very good. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah.
Anyone else want to accept?
Okay.
Minister, right. Come on out. Amen.
Now, some of you may get a chance to say something twice today now.
That's right. Amen.
How can we relate to one another with love?
I thank God for my sisters. They did an excellent job. Mm-hmm. Love is the fruit of the Spirit. And in John 3:16, he said, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish but have an everlasting life." And also in the Word, he tells us that if we don't love one another, how can we say we love him
yeah.
and we never seen him before? So how can we confess that we say we love him, but we don't treat each other like we're supposed to here?
Yes, yes.
And I thank God for the women's ministry, and also that we came back today to reconnect and to be refreshed with one another. Also, love is, it's like the sister said, an action word. If I say that I love you, but I got your name spread everywhere,
right.
That's not
right.
love.
That's
amen.
Right. Amen.
And if I need to talk to that person, I should go to that person. Everybody in the church should know that. So that's love, that if I'm able to go to my sister and ask her, can I talk to her, you know. And that's how we keep the love in the body of Christ.
That's right.
And that's right. Keep the... skillsism out, and
right.
you got cliques and stuff. That's how we keep that out of church.
Yes,
we
right.
show
right.
the godly love.
That's
amen.
Right. Amen.
Yes,
amen.
That was good. That's a good answers. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Yes. Okay. Let's see. Can you take it? Uh-huh.
Yes.
Can you swing it around, sister?
Yes.
Okay.
All right. We have Minister Juice.
Yeah. Oh, we were not going to let you get out without doing hallelujah.
I think, and I agree with my sisters on what's already been said, but love is also correction.
Amen. Yes.
I love this church because we tell the truth. We tell the word of God. If you see me going in an area, and I'm supposed to be your sister, and you can't come to me and say, nah, you shouldn't have wore that to church, or something that I might be doing wrong. Because the Bible says, whom the Lord loves, he chastens.
That's right.
So if you're going to see me doing wrong and ain't going to never say nothing, how can you say you love me?
That's right. That's right.
So it's not only doing and being and loving, it's all that, and that's good.
Mm-hmm.
But when it comes to the correction in our life, and we're supposed to be sisters and loving one another, and you're going to go to Sally Sue maybe and tell her, well, my problem is
right.
come to me. Yeah.
Come on,
if you
come
got a problem with me,
that's right.
The Bible said, go to them or take two or three witnesses
mm-hmm.
and get that thing corrected, because we know the author of confusion is the devil.
Yes.
He does not want us to be unified as one
no.
another word.
No.
He don't like this,
no.
but he can't do nothing to stop
that's
it
right.
because
that's
we don't
right.
belong to him.
That's right.
So I thank God for the love of chastening
yes.
and correcting
yes.
and maturing behind all, because you're mature. When you're being corrected,
that's
you're
right.
doing something wrong, and somebody in love,
amen.
You know, you can say things different ways,
right.
but when you say it in love,
mm-hmm.
you know, you might get you warm in the beginning, but you realize she was telling me the truth. She told me that because she loved me.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what I got out of what love is, just correction.
Amen.
Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah,
that
was good.
That was very good, man.
Hallelujah.
Very good.
I see one more waving back there. Oh, were you waving? You going to come up? Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Praise God. I just want to say this about love. Love is also spiritual.
you should be able, the Bible says, know no man after the flesh, but after the spirit. So just because your sister doesn't say something is going on, or that she's just not feeling the part, or she's just been overwhelmed, we should be able to sense that. Because it's a spiritual connection.
It is.
Because for a person like myself, I have a lot of responsibilities. I'm not always going to say anything. But to you that know me by the Spirit, you get it in the Spirit and you begin to pray for your sister, or you begin to encourage. Love is also not turning a deaf eye to what you're going through and forgetting about what someone else is going through.
Right, right.
Because God put us first when he gave his only begotten son. So sometimes we get to be selfish, and that's not love. Sometimes you have to put yourself aside and see about your sister. Because the world would say, you're going through yourself, so forget about her. Not so. If we are true believers, we should always be looking, asking God, who needs to see your love today?
Amen. That's right, man.
So
that's
I would say this. Just know people after the spirit, and you can't miss it. Don't know them after the flesh. Love moves. Love does not stand still. Amen.
Amen. God bless. Thank you, sis.
Amen.
Amen. Well, that was great. That was wonderful. Amen. We have three more words up here. Three more. So let's go to that next word. Who wants to come up and pull the word out of the cup? Who wants to come and pull the next word? Don't have us to call names, because you know we will. You know we will. Amen.
And remember, there's no wrong answer.
That's
we're
right.
Just talking about how we relate to one another.
That's
in the
right.
Church.
We'll
when we say we're women of the
Amen.
Word, we want to be women of the Word.
Amen.
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 Okay. What word did you pull, sis?
Unity.
Unity.
Praise God.
Amen. Unity.
Yes. Unity. The Word of God tells us that we should operate in unity.
Amen.
That's
right. Amen.
The scripture is in my heart, and my mouth won't even connect with my heart. I just said that, but we should operate in unity.
Amen.
Yes. We should fellowship with one another.
Amen.
First of all, the pastors were actually encouraging us on this thing with community way before it manifested.
That's right.
It came to be.
That's right.
It was a, what, 1 year? Was it, this is 24 was about, was it 23 or was it even 22, at the end of 22? Well, they introduced it to us. They actually spoke about it. And actually, they spoke it into being. It became real.
Amen.
Amen. That's right.
That we should go deeper than what we were doing in the Word of God.
Amen.
That we should study to show ourselves approved and spread it with our brothers and sisters in Christ. That we should grow together.
That's right.
Unity does that.
Amen.
In community. We're all together. Mm-hmm. And we learn from the word that God has given to the messenger.
Mm-hmm.
In unity. And when we fail to meet in the mornings, we are on at 9 o'clock on Sunday. Make that clear. On Sunday at 9 o'clock. Some people say it's like Sunday school, but I think it's deeper.
It is.
It's way deeper than Sunday school.
It is. It is.
I mean, I went to Sunday school.
That's right.
So I know what Sunday school, the position that Sunday school was, and what this does to all of us who attends. The word is expounded on, and actually, we may have heard a little of it, but never to the point whereby the messenger explains it to us.
Yes. Yes.
And the way she explains it to us,
yes. Yes.
We know it's from God.
That's right. That's right.
So it's just really beautiful, and when we gather together, we're actually growing together.
That's
we
right.
are maturing in the things
that's
of God.
Right. That's right.
And if you never come and gone back there, you might say, "Oh, that's so early, aren't you?" Oh, it's early for all of us. We right. have to actually press.
That's right.
We have to press.
That's right. That's right. That's right.
Now, can I throw this out? What happens, sister, if there is no unity in the church, in the women's group, and whatever group? What problems come up if there's no unity involved with God's people?
Well, all kinds of problems. Mm-hmm. Division.
Yes.
Someone spoke about the schisms. Schisms in the church.
Right.
Whereas one group over here, and it may not appear to be like that in the church.
Mm-hmm.
It may not appear, but you can tell it's you can actually tell that it's going on.
Uh-oh.
All you have to do is say, nope, and it's nobody. Mm-hmm. No, nobody that's crazy.
That's right.
You know, we can actually sense that.
Yes.
And we have the Holy Spirit that lives inside of us.
Yes.
There you go.
Yes, yes, yes.
And it just, you know, opens our eyes and our heart to see. And we might want to, you know, look over it. But when the heart is offended, when you are offended by a sister or brother, and it's usually going to be sisters, you all.
Come on.
It's just something about the genders.
Yes.
Men don't usually operate that way.
Right.
It is us women.
Right. Right.
And we should not.
That's right.
You know, everything should operate in love.
That's right.
Because he loves us.
Yes.
He does.
Yes.
So much that he gave his only son for us.
Yes.
To die on the cross, to die for us.
Yes.
And when he did that, he did away with so much. He healed us. Yes, he set us free from so much. And we should not let the devil operate, be that strong hold in our lives.
That's right.
We should not.
That's right.
Because we know that he has an assignment.
That's right.
To kill, steal, and destroy.
That's right.
And if you allow him to do that, that is what he will do.
That's right.
And we will not. We will not unify.
That's right.
We will not become in unity with one another.
That's right.
Hallelujah. And
that's right.
And that's what God wants us to,
that's
to
right.
do.
That's right.
He wants us to operate in unity.
Hey,
praise God.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Anybody want to add?